Good morning guys, today I'll explain that how you can set up your WordPress site with ContentStudio, how you can manage your plugins. Starting off, you have to make sure that you have updated version of ContentStudio plugin installed on your dashboard. Go to your plugins, add new, install the latest version that is also there in the documentation for ContentStudio. So let's say I'm just a user starting off and don't know a thing about ContentStudio. I've just migrated my account and I'm just trying to learn the step-by-step process. So I'll just go into docs.contentstudio.io. I'll try to locate WordPress connection. So I'll have to go to integration. Right there, I'll have WordPress blog connection, how to connect WordPress blog. Get into it. And I'll try to locate the method. This is always the preferred method, ContentStudio WordPress plugin, that requires an updated ContentStudio plugin installed on your WordPress dashboard. So the link is right there. Click on this link, download it, and install it right here. Upload plugin, choose the file, install it, and you'll see right here. Immediately you'll be showing up with a successful connection. Now you need an API for ContentStudio plugin, so you can get it right here. Copy it and just paste it to make sure the connection is 100% successful. So once you do that, now it comes, this is the first step that you need to do on WordPress dashboard. Now you'll come over here to connect the blog on ContentStudio platform. Get into the blog sites, enter your URL, make sure it's correct, username and password. This method, we have three methods. First one is always preferred, and there are more than 95% chances that your blog, if you don't have any inappropriate plugin that has not yet been whitelisted, installed on your WordPress dashboard, it is going to be 100% connected from ContentStudio. So let's say I'm a user, I'm not sure how many plugins I need to whitelist, how to do it, and what kind of issues I'm going to be facing while I have those inappropriate plugins installed on WordPress. So let's say I have Jetpack, WordFence, similar plugins that are actually that need to be whitelisted. I'll just throw my head and I'll just get into the documentation one more time. Go back in, try to locate some troubleshooting articles that we have on our website. So I'll go ahead with WordPress connection. Here I see how I need to whitelist the IPs. I get some plugin API key verification articles as well. So now my concern is to whitelist some of the plugins. So these are the list of plugins, possible plugins that you need to be whitelisted. With these IPs, you need to just enter, get into your WordPress plugin. Let's say it's iTheme Security. So get into the settings of iTheme Security. There will be there a section with named with I guess whitelist management. So get into your whitelist management and whitelist all these IPs. Just need to copy this from this document here. Just whitelist this, and I mean, this is only a one-time job. I want you guys to get it right in the first place in order to avoid any issues going forward. So this is a complete process. If you're having issues with feature images on your blog post, if you're having issues with some descriptions or titles, make sure you follow all this step-by-step process mentioned in all these documentations. So I hope this is served. In the next video, I'll be explaining some use cases about how you can best utilize cover stories, how you can best utilize the topics and sites. So until then, take good care of yourself, people. Have a wonderful day.